In today's video, I'm going to present a new method for dissolving platinum without using aqua regia. I have a piece of platinum wire that I plan to use for electroplating platinum onto electrodes. Normally, to make hexachlroroplatinic acid, we would use aqua regia, which is a mixture of hydrochloric acid and nitric acid heated to high temperatures. This process is quite dangerous due to the toxic fumes it produces, and it also requires nitric acid, which I prefer to avoid due to its hazardous nature. Instead, I'm going to take a safer approach and use electrolysis in hydrochloric acid. By doing this, I can dissolve the platinum and create the hexachloroplatinic acid. Caution! Hydrochloric acid is corrosive and dangerous to the skin and eyes. The hexachloroplatinic acid we are going to make is highly toxic. For the electrolysis setup, I'm going to use a carbon electrode as the cathode and the platinum wire as the anode. Now, several research papers explain that to prevent the platinum from passivating, it's important to use either a very low current or alternating current. To achieve this, I'll be using a low frequency signal generator and applying a square wave. With this setup, we're kind of breaking away from the traditional concept of a distinct cathode and anode, since the alternating current means the roles of the electrodes are constantly switching. However, these studies suggest that adding a small DC offset voltage to the signal can help the process. Now, I'm setting up the entire system. The electrolysis will take place in a very small container. I've set the frequency to 100 Hz for now, but based on what I've read in some articles, it might be better to use a lower frequency, like 10 Hz for better efficiency. For the amplitude, I've initially set it to 2 volts, but I'll increase it later once I see the voltage drop across the solution. You can observe the signal on the oscilloscope as I make these adjustments. I'm also adding a 50 ohm resistor in series with the circuit to protect my signal generator. The generator isn't designed to handle high currents, so the resistor will help prevent any damage while still allowing the system to operate safely. Now that everything is set up, I'm going to pour in the hydrochloric acid. This is a 23% solution, but I don't think the exact concentration is crucial for this process. The system works and the electrolysis has begun, with a few bubbles forming. Platinum will oxidize and dissolve as hexachloroplatinic acid. After just a few minutes, the solution starts to turn slightly yellow, then increasingly so over the hours. Here's the result after leaving the electrolysis running overnight. As you can see, the solution has become more orange. Even though the solution is very colorful, the concentration of hexachloroplatinic acid is still quite low. As for the platinum wire itself, you can see that the end has been slightly corroded from the electrolysis. Next, I'll evaporate the hydrochloric acid by heating the solution. The remaining orange residue is the hexachloroplatinic acid that has been formed. It's a small amount, but it's more than enough for electrode plating. I'll be using this to create a fuel cell, and I'll show you that step in a future episode.